Today, we're going to tell you exactly how to get your EV terms right. There's a lot of confusing information about electromobility out there. So maybe you heard about amperes, volts, kilowatts, kilowatt hours, whatever. We want to give you the details you need to know to be EV ready.
There are various types of EVs on the market, but when most people talk about EVs, they mean battery electric vehicles, or BEVs, like this Tesla I'm driving. A BEV is a fully electric vehicle which has a battery where it stores all its energy. And this battery can be loaded again and again by charging it. Now let's understand the common terms most BEV drivers face every day.
So let's start with kilowatt hours. A German with a sausage. What a stereotype. So imagine this is your EV battery. The amount of meat in that sausage is equal to the amount of energy stored in the battery. So this is considered kilowatt hours. For example, the Tesla comes with a 77 kilowatt hour battery. Now let's talk about kilowatts. So when you look at the sausage, the meat needs to go into the casing. The rate of what the meat is going into the sausage is equal to the rate of what the energy is flowing into the battery. And that is what is called kilowatts.
In Germany, you are most likely to find 11 kilowatt chargers in cities. In small towns or the countryside, you find up to 50 kilowatt chargers. And on highways, you find chargers with an average of 350 kilowatts. Now let's talk about amperes. This isn't a term that you are going to worry about at most external charging stations, but it does matter if you are trying to charge your EV at home or at random plug points.
The amount of current going through the wire is called ampere.
So an ampere is a unit of measure of electric current. And you need to know how many amperes a line can take to prevent damaging the line or the device, in this case, an electric vehicle.
Otherwise, this is a consequence, a burnt socket.
Or worse. But now on to volts.
The force used to push the current is called volts. Actually, the thicker the cable, the more volts, the more ampere is possible.
Volts have an influence on charging speed. A lot of EVs, including this Tesla Model 3 Performance, charge with 400 volt technology. But some EV manufacturers, like Kia, Porsche and Audi, are switching to 800 volt technology. To enable even faster charging.
Speaking about charging EVs, if you ever wonder why sometimes people take out their very own cable and plug it into the charger, or sometimes they pull out the cable from the charger and into the car, is related to two more very important EV terms. So AC and DC charging. This, for example, is AC charging.
AC, or alternating current, is how energy is usually supplied. But DC, or direct current, is the energy that batteries are typically capable of taking. So usually when you take a cable out of your car and plug it into a charger, what you're doing is taking alternating current and sending it into the car, where the car's converter changes it to direct current for the battery to store. But when you take the cable straight out of the charger, you're usually sending direct current straight into the car's battery, because a conversion happens within the external charger. So logically, this is usually much faster.
I've just finished my charging at an AC charger with a Type 2 cable. If you wonder what a Type 2 cable is, stay tuned for our next video and I will explain you how to charge your EV absolutely anywhere. Want more EV terms explained? Let us know in the comments below. If you like this video, subscribe to DW Rev.